Hello, hello, good day, ladies and gents. My name is Dylan, and today on the channel, we're going to learn the ins and outs of speed ramping in Final Cut Pro. Speed ramping, also called time remapping, is the speeding up and slowing down of footage for a dramatic effect. If you remember the movie 300, the fight scenes in that movie have some pretty awesome examples of speed ramping, and also this B-roll product shot craze that's been going on recently has a ton of examples of speed ramps as well. So while filming, here are some tips that'll help you to get the best looking and smoothest speed ramps. We're gonna specifically focus on speed ramp transitions today because once you know how to have them looking good in your videos, speed ramping on a single clip is no biggie. Number one, make sure your shots are stable and don't have a lot of jitters. If you have a gimbal, use it. Even having small shakes or unwanted camera movement can take away from those buttery smooth speed ramps we all want to achieve. Yes, you can use a stabilizer in post, but that won't always work perfectly. Filming tip number two, make sure your shot or shots are moving in the same direction or have the same movement. So for example, if your shot is moving forwards, it's best to create a speed ramp transition into another stable shot moving forward. This isn't always the case though, but in my opinion, having the movement be the same in your shots yields the best looking results. Filming tip number three, make sure you film for long enough for each clip. I say this because if you have a clip that's only a couple seconds long, there will only be so much footage left after you speed up a section of it. Something I suggest doing to help make the footage drag out longer and to help the effect of the speed ramp look more dramatic is to shoot in slow motion. So film in a higher frame rate so when you come out of that quick speed in the clip or between clips, you get some nice contrast of really fast to really slow. The last tip while filming before we jump into Final Cut is make sure you cover enough distance with your camera movement. So if you're doing a slide to the left, make sure it's not a very small slide. If you're dolling in, try and push in as close as you can. Visual distance is going to be your friend here. The reason for this is because not only will it make you film a longer clip so you have more room to add a speed ramp where you like, but it also makes the speed ramp look smoother. So let's first create a speed ramp transition for these two clips. You want to find where in your first clip you want the speed to quickly pick up to transition to the next shot. Because this second shot I have is just a slow slide parallel to these storage boxes, I want my first clip to end about when the storage scooter is parallel and moving to the left of the camera. Remember, we want that motion and the movement to be nearly the same between the two shots for the speed ramp to look real smooth. I don't want the rest of this shot since the camera movement is moving forwards and the beginning of the second shot is sliding left. I'll trim this by pressing Option Right Bracket. Next, I'll find the point where I want the shot to start picking up speed. Usually what I do is use my skimmer by pressing S on the keyboard and do kind of a preview of how it would look. So I basically pretend to have the speed ramp completed with my skimmer. Press Shift B to make the retime point in the clip, and you can double click on this speed bar up top, or you can click on this arrow and go into fast to change the speed. I usually choose the arrow option because 9 times out of 10 I go with either 8 times or 20 times depending on the clip. Here I'll choose 20 times. Next, we'll do the same for the second clip. I want to choose to speed up more of a section of this clip because I was moving the camera very slowly while filming. If I don't extend the speed ramp so it covers some distance in this section, it'd look like this. It looks like we speed ramped into a wall. So let's go about here, press Shift B and choose 20 times speed. That honestly looks pretty good, but if you need to, and most of the time you will, adjust the ease in and ease out of the speed ramp by pulling on these bars. The farther you extend the bars, the slower the change in speed will be. The shorter you make them, the more abrupt and quickly your change in speed will be. Say later on you want to change something with the speed of the clip, but you don't see those speed indicator bars that you saw before. So what you'll do is you'll click on the clip, press Command R, and they will pop up again. Something that's also helpful to know, if you double click on this point, click Edit Source Frame, you can change when that speed ramp starts or ends in your clip. This is super helpful and can save you a lot of time when adjusting your speed ramps. I hope this helped you out, and if it did, if you learned at least one thing, do me a solid and press the thumbs up button, comment what you learned, and make sure to subscribe if you have not already and you would like to learn more Final Cut Pro and filmmaking techniques. I will see you guys next week. Have a great day.